Hello everyone, this is Dr. Adel Bondok, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. I will talk about the anatomy of the rectum. So I will talk about the length and the position, the extent, flexures and the valves, peritoneal covering, relations, blood supply and the nerve supply, and the lymph drainage. Okay, this is the sigmoid colon and this is the rectum. So start by the length of the rectum. The rectum is 5 inches long. The position, it is located in the lower and the posterior part of the pelvic cavity. The extent, the beginning and the end. It begins opposite the third piece of the sacrum at the continuation of the sigmoid colon. It ends at the rectoanal angle, which is about 1 inch below and in front of the tip of the coccyx. Then I will talk about flexures. We have two types of flexures, anteroposterior and lateral. The two anteroposterior flexures are sacral flexure, follow the concavity of the sacrum, and the peroneal flexure at the rectoanal angle. So regarding the rectum, it is 5 inches long. It is located in the lower and the posterior part of the pelvis. It begins opposite the third piece of the sacrum as the continuation of the sigmoid colon. It ends at the rectoanal angle, which is 1 inch below and in front of the tip of the coccyx. It continues as the anal canal. Actually, the rectoanal angle is formed by the contraction, is formed by the tone of the puborectalis part of the levator ani. Regarding the anteroposterior flexures, anteroposterior flexures are two. Sacral flexure. This sacral flexure is concave anteriorly, okay? And it follows the concavity of the sacrum. Then peroneal flexure. This peroneal flexure is concave backward and it is present at the rectoanal angle. Regarding the lateral flexures, this is the right wall of the rectum and this is the left wall. The three lateral flexures are the upper and the lower are concave to the left. The middle flexure is concave to the right. Opposite each concavity, there is a rectal valve. So we have three rectal valves. Upper rectal valve or superior rectal valve from the left wall. Middle rectal valve from the right wall. And inferior rectal valve from the left wall. So we have the regarding the lateral flexures, upper and lower are concave to the left, the middle flexure is concave to the right, and opposite each concavity there is a rectal valve, superior rectal valve, middle rectal valve, and inferior rectal valve. The superior and the inferior rectal valves arise from the left wall of the rectum. The middle rectal valve arises from the right wall of the rectum. What is the importance of the rectal valves? Rectal valves are very important because they support the feces as they descend in the rectum. So they prevent early descent of the feces. Second importance of the rectal valve is that in sigmoidoscopy, we have to be aware of the three rectal valves. Two in the left rectal wall and one in the right rectal wall. Regarding the peritoneal covering of the rectum is divided into three parts. The upper third of the rectum is covered in front and the sides, and on each side of the upper third there is pararectal fossa. This is the pararectal fossa. So the upper third covered in front and the sides, and it is surrounded by the pararectal fossa. Regarding the middle third, it is covered anteriorly with peritoneum, Regarding the lower third, it is not covered with peritoneum. Regarding the posterior relation of the rectum, actually the posterior relation of the rectum is the anterior relation of the sacrum. So let me remind you of the anterior relation of the sacrum. Three muscles. This is the iliacus, and then piriformis, and then coccygeus muscle. Then artery in the midline. This is the median sacral artery, median sacral artery, and the glomus coccygeum. The nerve, sympathetic chain, and the two chains unite by ganglion impar. Then artery entering the sacral foramina, lateral sacral arteries. Then nerves coming out from the sacral foramina, ventral rami of the upper four sacral nerves. And regarding the ala of the sacrum, it is related to lumbosacral trunk, obturator nerve, and in between the iliolumbar artery. So regarding the rectum, let me cover the upper two pieces of the sacrum. So this is the third piece of the sacrum where the rectum begins. So actually, the posterior relation of the rectum, 12 structures. The 12 structures are four threes in the midline, three in the midline, three muscles, three vessels, and three nerves. The three in the midline, of course, the sacrum, the lower three pieces of the sacrum, then coccyx, and then anococcygeal body. Three muscles, piriformis, coccygeus, and levator inferior. Three vessels or three arteries, okay? Median sacral artery, lateral sacral arteries, and the superior rectal artery behind the rectum. Three nerves. This is the first one. Sympathetic chains. Okay, lower sacral nerves. Coccygeal nerve and sympathetic chains. So these are the structures behind the rectum, 12 structures. Then anterior relation in the male. Anterior relation in the male, upper two thirds and the lower one third. Upper two thirds related to the rectovesical pouch, and this pouch contains small intestine and the sigmoid colon. The lower third is related to the base of the urinary bladder and the seminal vesicle and the prostate gland. Regarding the anterior relation in the female, this is the uterus, this is the vagina. So anterior relation in the female, upper two thirds and the lower one third. Upper two thirds, recto uterine pouch or recto vaginal pouch or Douglas pouch containing a small intestine and sigmoid colon. The lower third is related to the vagina. Regarding the lateral relation on each side of the rectum, upper third and the lower two thirds. This is according to the peritoneal covering, because the upper third is covered on each side with peritoneum. So the upper third is related to the pararectal fossa containing the small intestine. The lower two thirds are related to three structures, fat covering levator ani and ischiorectal fossa. So fat over levator ani and ischiorectal fossa. So on each side of the rectum, on each side of the upper third, pararectal fossa. On each side of the lower two thirds, fat over levator ani and ischiorectal fossa. Regarding the blood supply of the rectum, it is supplied by four arteries and four veins, and drained by four veins. The four arteries are three rectal arteries and the median sacral artery. The median sacral artery arises from the abdominal aorta, from the back of the abdominal aorta. Regarding the three rectal arteries, superior, middle, and inferior. The superior rectal artery is a branch or is the continuation of the inferior mesenteric artery. The middle rectal artery is a branch from the internal iliac artery. The inferior rectal artery is a branch from the internal pudendal artery. So again, the four arteries supplying the rectum. Median sacral artery, this is the median sacral artery, and the three rectal arteries, superior rectal artery, middle rectal artery, and inferior rectal artery. Regarding the superior rectal artery, this is the superior rectal artery. It is the continuation of the inferior mesenteric artery. This is the superior rectal artery in green color, continuation of the inferior mesenteric artery, and it is the main artery of the rectum. It supplies the mucous membrane of the rectum. Second one, middle rectal artery. This is the middle rectal artery. It is a branch from the internal iliac artery, from the anterior division of the internal iliac artery, and it mainly supplies the muscle layer. And then inferior rectal artery, from the internal pudendal artery, it supplies the lower end of the rectum and the anal canal. And then median sacral artery arises from the back of the abdominal aorta, and it supplies the posterior wall of the rectum. Regarding the veins, superior rectal vein continues as the inferior mesenteric vein, and the anterior mesenteric vein drains into the splenic vein. Middle rectal vein drains into the internal iliac vein. Inferior rectal vein drains into the internal pudendal vein, and the median sacral vein drains into the left common iliac vein. Regarding the nerve supply of the rectum is supplied by the pelvic plexus, which is called inferior hypogastric plexus. And this inferior hypogastric plexus is present on each side of the rectum. The inferior hypogastric plexus, or the pelvic plexus, is formed by sympathetic fibers and the parasympathetic fibers. Sympathetic fibers from the lumbar splanchnic nerves L1 and L2 through the superior hypogastric plexus. Regarding the parasympathetic fibers, arise from the pelvic splanchnic nerves, which arise from S2, 3, and 4. Regarding lymph drainage of the rectum, this is the rectum. Lymph drainage of the rectum drains to the pararectal lymph nodes. And from the pararectal lymph nodes, lymphatics go to upper 2/3 and the lower 1/3. Upper 2/3 along the superior rectal artery to the inferior mesenteric lymph nodes. The lower 1/3 along the middle rectal artery and inferior rectal artery to the internal iliac lymph nodes. So the lymph drainage of the rectum, pararectal lymph nodes. The pararectal lymph nodes from the upper 2/3 of the rectum to the superior rectal artery. Along the superior rectal artery to the inferior mesenteric lymph nodes. The lower 1/3 of the rectum along the middle rectal artery and along the inferior rectal artery to the internal iliac lymph nodes. So the ultimate drainage of the rectum to the inferior mesenteric lymph nodes and the internal iliac lymph nodes. Regarding rectal cancer, rectal cancer spreads along three roots. The three roots are: the early root is along lymphatics to the inferior mesenteric and the internal iliac lymph nodes. And the late root is along the inferior mesenteric vein to the liver. And the direct root to the surrounding organs like the urinary bladder, seminal vesicle, prostate, vagina, sacral plexus, and so on. And thank you very much. Best wishes and good luck.